I don't feel confident starting conversations. I don't know how to introduce myself to others. I don't know how to start a conversation with somebody I don't know at all. If you've heard yourself saying any one of these, then this video is for you. Hello everyone, I'm Mansi Agarwal, International Soft Skills Corporate Trainer, and every week I share with you one tip that can help you enhance your personality or your communication skills. And for this week, the topic is elevator pitch or how to introduce ourselves. This, of course, is a huge part of communication, and this is basically a 30 to 40 second introduction of ourselves that leaves a positive impact on the person we are talking to. So, what is the end goal of an elevator pitch? Its short 30 to 40 second length makes it absolutely appropriate to be said in one elevator ride. But please remember, this is not a sales pitch. This is not a job interview. You're definitely not getting to try and to get the other person to give you a job or to buy something from you. Absolutely not. The only thing that you want at the end of the elevator pitch is for you to leave an impact on the other person and hopefully get a second conversation with them. Parts of an elevator pitch. While an elevator pitch could have many different varieties, you could be introducing your company to somebody, you could be introducing your product to somebody. What I'm going to talk about here is how you can make a basic introduction of yourself that is professional and impactful at the same time. Part one, name and what you do. It's really simple. What is your name and what is your profession? For me, it would be, hi, I'm Mansi Agarwal. I'm an international corporate trainer and a transformational speaker. Simple. Part two, what are the problems you solve? This part is really about explaining to the other person what value you add to the world. What is the real implication of what you do? For me, it would be something like this. Hey, basically, as a transformational speaker, I'm a dream enabler. I help people change the words they use for themselves. I also help people by giving them motivational thoughts and other strategies that they can use to change their lives. That is the problem I solve. So, this would be the second part of my elevator pitch. Part three, what is your USP or your highest achievement? This really is the part which grabs all the attention. Think about it like this. Talk about the pinnacle of your success. For me, my USP or my unique selling point might be that all my trainings and all my sessions are completely customized. Besides, I'm also a TEDx speaker and a distinguished Toastmaster, and I make videos, I create content on the internet, which has been viewed around 10 million times in total. Part four, the question or the hook. Right at the end of the elevator pitch, you want to ask the other person a question. The purpose of this question is to hook them into a conversation with you, is to engage them and potentially start a much longer and interesting conversation. The questions I like to ask are relevant to what I do, as well as something that might make sense to them, that might interest them. Examples could be, so, have you ever attended a corporate training workshop? Or something like, have you ever watched any one of my videos? I find that if the person answers these questions positively, then we have a great conversation based on mutual interest that we can look forward to. Two little points to remember. Number one, have your business card handy to give away if the conversation goes off well. I generally don't do that, but I like to connect with people on social media platforms such as LinkedIn, so it's just a much more intimate way to keep in touch. The other thing, of course, is that your elevator pitch should also be customized, keeping in mind the person you're talking to. I hope with this, each one of you is able to not only come up with a great elevator pitch for yourself, but also practice it so that you sound authentic and you're able to impact the other person in the best possible way. All the best.